I used to carry coupons around. I was like a people who used to make fun of at work. Hey, here comes the coupon guy. I've been with the company exactly 15 years. This December it'll be 15 years. I came to America to do my master's in computer science. January 2000 is when I came here. But I've never flew in an airplane before. P&G is the leading issuer of coupons in US. We spend around $500 million a year in US on coupons. Out of that, 300 million is on paper coupons. What was going on was counterfeiters have figured out a way to alter the value of the coupons and were able to redeem the coupons at the retailers without getting caught. So the impact was companies like P&G had to pay those money that the retailers were redeeming for the shoppers. By the time it's 2019, it was more than 15 million a year, no solution, they came to us and said, hey, can NGS help with this? We hear you guys work on some cool stuff. The market ops finance governance leader, Kurt Jackson, I remember meeting him for the first time in TN13. He brought those brand saver coupons. He was so passionate about the problem. I had no idea what coupons are. You know, I've never used them. He talked about the problem. And I tried to ask him, like everybody else, why can't we just go digital, right? You know, in this world, why do we use paper coupons? So he said, hey, Google P&G. And I did. The first review that showed up at the time, again, this was two years ago, was, oh, P&G used to be good. They stopped issuing coupons. I'm not a big fan of the company. I became member of Facebook groups for coupons. I interacted with coupon fraud people. I really got obsessed, learned nitty-gritty details of the coupon, understood everything, how a coupon gets created, to how what happens when everything gets settled. I actually went to Mexico tracking the whole process of what happens after a coupon gets redeemed at a retailer. You know, follow the coupons, went to Mexico, that's where the clearinghouse is, and looked at what they do there. The counterfeit coupon problem, even though it impacts P&G and companies like us, from the retailer standpoint, they're getting paid. So for them, the counterfeit problem was not a big deal. It was only impacting us. What if I create a system that the manufacturer trusts, you know, hey, can see almost real time what is being redeemed. The retailer can trust that, you know, has been redeemed at the stores, all are captured, and nobody could change that. That's when the big idea for me sparked. Basically, again, that's what blockchain as a technology, that's what it's meant for, perfect use case for the technology. I'm from a family of five brothers, and I'm the middle child, right? You know, how the middle child syndrome, I have to prove everything. So that really helped me to work hard, you know, have this attitude of, I can do it. If he can do it, I can do it, and never give up. Luckily, I didn't have to turn around. You know, right now, Cube is live in 10,000 stores. I think it's just going. We are just scratching the surface. This is not just a P&G solution. This is going to be the industry solution. We need to patent this idea because it's going to get out soon. We applied for a patent coupon fraud elimination using blockchain. If you Google my name, it will show up. It's a provisional patent still. I think we are almost there. During COVID, we made it happen, right? We did everything remotely. The industry we are trying to disrupt, it's like 60-year-old industry. It's a gradual disruption. And as we disrupt and digitize the back office processing, we are going to get much more benefit as a company. The future is going to be the one day where redeem a coupon at the store and they have a shredder next to them and then throw it in there, boom, right? Then they get paid, everybody's happy. That's the future for where it should be. I love it, you know. You guys could talk about coupons to me any day. You know, I love what I've learned.